Hey everyone, welcome to the next video where we talk about how to customize your GitHub profile somewhat like me. All right, so I'm just not boasting about how my profile looks better or not. There are like a number of profiles which looks much more better than mine. So I'm just giving you a heads up like how you can scale up from this kind of profile to somewhat look like this. Now in the last video, the one above in your playlist, you can see I talk about this particular application where you can see awesome GitHub readme profiles where 100 of good developers has listed their profile on the kind of small project which I'm running. So you can click over here and go to their respective profile and see how and what they have been added, and you can directly click on edit button, and if you like any kind of feature, you can click on edit button and you can copy from there. So this would be an amazing add-on to your profile. And again, it's basically like there is no perfect profile right out there. All you can do is like customize and do it much more optimized for people to come and read and, you know, see what you're offering to them. So this is a very good way, and you can make it much more funny as well. So that would be amazing way for you to do it. So I'm not jumping into how to make it easy. So in the last video, I spoke about how to create a special readme profile like this. I'm giving the link over in the description so you can go and watch it. All right, in this video, we are going to talk about how to add or edit your profile. Now you can see a lot of information available for me over here, where I work, where I'm living in, and my email address and my website and my social media links. So if you want to add that, click on the edit profile. Either you can click it here or you can go to the settings and you can click on settings and you can click on edit. So that's a bit tiring way. So I would directly click over here and click on name, bio, and all these details you can add. And if you want some reference apart from me as well, always the link is there in the description box. So you can always go here and find how other people has been added, and you can get an inspiration from them and you can copy paste it, or you can do ChatGPT as well. So then eventually you can optimize it. I don't know who added this button, but yeah. All right. So that would be the thing for how to add your GitHub readme profile, and make sure that you have a profile photo. All you need to do is like click on the profile photo, click on the edit button, upload your photo. All right. Now that would be one thing. And if you have Orchid ID is for the research people. So you can add that as well. So that's how it looks like this. Now, what you need to do is like, you have two options over here. Either you have to include your private contribution on your profile. So make sure that if you want to add that streak to be counted in your private repo as well, click on this one and make sure that this is unchecked. So update the preference over here. Now you have updated that and available for jobs. Now GitHub do offer you to get a job. So click on available for jobs as well. All right. So you save your job profile. So that's why the whole point of this particular thing is like customizing and improving your profiles. So this is amazing thing, right? Now, preferred spoken language, you can select that and save the trending settings. All right. Then next thing you can see in my profile is like highlights. So the highlight tab is missing in your profile. So to get that, you can join the developer program member. So developer program member, again, you are in your settings page, in your public profile, scroll down over here and join the developer program member. So once you click over here, it will ask you support email address. So you can just give the email address as gmail.com. Just ignore this for right now. www.recodehive.com. Make sure that you have some portfolio page or any of the other page which you can link over here. So that would be great, right? So thanks for joining. Tell us about how that works. You can click on this link to know what are the developer program benefits you can get it from here. So and enjoy the kudos. Okay, register here. What is this registration? You already registered. Now use the GitHub Log 25. Okay, have an integration that works with GitHub. All right, so there is like, yeah, so you can just simply ignore this one right now. Okay, so what actually this enables you is like, this will be help you to integrate any of the GitHub API on your profile, and you know, GitHub will allow you to do it. Now when you go into your profile right now, let me go back to the profile. Now you will be seeing an highlight tab with the part of developer program member, right? This is pretty amazing. Now on the next step, you want to join any organization. The link is there in the description. So what I would recommend you guys is like, click on the description. There are different organizations I have listed where you can directly click on invite link and join. So this is like an automated process. So if you come to over here and click on the invite link over here, and you will be able to join this organization. All you need to do is like enter your GitHub profile username. So mine is NJKB. Click on submit new issues and give us a Discord username if you have any. Tell us why do you would like to work with us, or what you want to do, or any of your achievements which you have done. Or if you don't want to do it, just fill it blank and click on submit new issues. So you will be getting an automated email to join the organization. So once you join the organization, you will be able to see that, okay, you've been part of the organization. But if you want to list it like this, what you need to do is like click on once you join the organization, what you can see is like go to the particular organization data inside. You won't be able to click like how I clicked before. So you have to be here, click on people and search by your name if you already joined. Okay, search by your name and click this private into public. So now what happens is like public people can see that which organization you've been part of, and there is will be a new tab opened over here. So that's how it works. So all right, and that's how the all about joining the profile. So by end of this video, if you follow all these rules, you will be having a profile button. And if you click over here, for example, if you click over here, you can set a custom emoji, never PC, or you can just put an emoji over here and say that what your current status is all about. If you're driving, set status is like a status thing, so people can see what you are all about. You're able to see this one, description and the social links, and achievements is not yet covered in this video, but I will be speaking about that in the next videos, and I will be talking about how you can get each one of these achievements in your profile. So that's going to be way too great addition for your profile to look amazing. Then you already have, I linked a couple of organizations in the description box, so you can go over there and join any of the organization just like how I did. And few of the organization like this, let me take you few organization like Legisure. So these people never let you to join, just like many of the organization won't be having the automated process. So you can only join once you start contributing to their open profile. For example, these people do help. So what this does is like this will help to code in your own language. So what you will be doing is like once you do first contribution, then they will be sending a request to join this particular organization. So most of the organization which you see on the GitHub is works in the same way, not like an automated invite. All right, now that's the thing. Now you will be having a profile by now. Then make sure that you pin a repository as well. You can click on customize your pin and select a few of the highly starred pins over here. So you will be able to pin that particular repository on your profile. Now it is much more simple. Look at this, how it was before and how it's getting improving one by one, right? Now in the contribution setting, you might have noticed, okay, you don't get to see this contribution chart. To be honest, I don't really care about the contribution streaks. It basically never tells you a complete whether you are a good coder or not. But when you're trying to join, or if you want to go as an open source contributor, this particular graph is very important. Now you might see that, okay, by default, this graph is disabled. You can click on this activity overview where you can enable this particular graph. Now this graph tells you your story. For example, if you look at my graph, so it's more inclined towards a code review. So this kind of gives an impression to any of the organization admin that, okay, you know something about pull requests, you know how to do code review, right? So they can invite you as a maintainer. Now, when I look into this particular graph, it's more or like commits and pull requests. So I am an open source contributor, right? So if I'm looking for an open source contributor, so this would be a right person because he been creating an issues, he been creating a commits, and he been doing a pull request. Unfortunately, he never did any code review, so I can't make him as a maintainer at this point of time, but I can train him to make a maintainer. So that's how the thought process on this particular graph is happening, and all these organization you've been part of, you doing. So that's all important. That's all like a key metrics when people look at. It's basically like your resume. All right. And here you can see a complete activity about how you've been doing. All right. Then what else I missed? The achievements tab. So now when you go into our awesome readme profile over here, scroll up to the top, you can see something called GitHub badges. So now GitHub badges do provide some achievement badges. This is like a basically a gamification. In order to get this badge, it's not that really easy. So I will be explaining you how to get the badges. A glimpse about how the badge is working over here is listed over here. How you can get the badges, and few of the badges you can get only one time. And for example, Starstruck is like if you have a repository and 16 people start your repository, you will be getting this default badge. And if 128 people start your repository, you get this one. And if 4,000 people start your repository, you get a gold one. So it's very impossible to get this until and unless you have to become an expert. And I will be explaining about how you can embed the Pair Extraordinary badge as well and Galaxy Brain. And these all badges are earnable right now. And these are the streaks which you need to add different categories of the badges. Now you can also set skin tone of your badges, just like click on the appearance settings over here, which will take you into the GitHub appearance setting, and you can select how your skin tone should look like over here. All right. And you can set whether the default theme according to the system or night theme is active right now, and you can set different themes. So this is allowed by GitHub. All right. And you can also set particular markdown sizes and tab sizes and everything. So that's like a kind of customization available to you. So these all are the badges which GitHub do provides you. For example, in the highlight, you can see developer program member and GitHub Pro actions. So Pro is for when you subscribe the Pro version. So that's like monthly $4 or $5. You already got this particular badge. Security Bounty Badge Hunter badge you only get when you become... when you solve any security related. So the link is given over here. Now we will talk about GitHub Campus Expert and we will be talking about security advisor credit. So these all things are like how the bug bounty program works. So when you give or things to the GitHub, so they will be adding that into your profile and you will be able to see only few people will get all these highlights over here. So that's how you can differentiate yourself from the other people, right? Now, on the other side, there are two badges which you can't earn right now, which is like RT contributor badge, which you can see in my profile. So this one was contributed to the repository in 2020. So all the code base, they stored in the Antarctica. So this was a project like that. And even similarly, they did the same programming to the Mars as well. So these two badges currently can't earn. And if you are looking for any kind of certification, I would recommend you to go and check this out. But this priced around $200. So it would be $100. And few of them are like pretty much expensive to take. So I would recommend if you want to go into a certification, watch all the playlist videos. So this will give you an insight into the GitHub Foundation. Then I will be also making a GitHub Actions video tutorial just similarly like this. I hope that would be helpful for you in the future. Now in the next video, I'll be talking about how you can get each of these badges like this. All right. Awesome. All right. So that's from my side. I hope you have a good profile by right now and experiment. Go to this particular page and try to experiment different badges here and there. That would be a great addition for your profile. Thank you for watching this video and I will be catching up with you in the next video where I will be talking about the GitHub badges. Thank you.